Good morning. Welcome to Zion Lutheran Church. I'm Pastor Steve. It's good to see all of you here in the sanctuary. Welcome to those who are listening on the radio on Cash 95.9 FM and those who are watching online on the internet. Praise God for all the ways technology allows us to share His Word. A couple announcements for this morning. First, tomorrow, the circuit pastors are having their monthly meeting here, and so the ladies are serving us breakfast. We're going to have a worship service tomorrow, and then we'll be meeting until from 9 until noon tomorrow. So if you're looking for me, I'll be stuck in a meeting. Woohoo! Everybody loves meetings. No, it'll be good. I love spending time with the other pastors. So we've got that going on. There are a number of announcements, like next Sunday we're supposed to be going sledding, but there's no snow. And as I asked last week, if anybody had any really brilliant ideas of something we could do, and nobody came up with anything incredibly brilliant. So our event for next Sunday, we're just going to cancel that. But we are having a potluck right after church, or right after the education hour next Sunday. So come and be a part of just getting to know each other and hanging out and sharing in the idea of being the body of Christ together. With that being said, one of the things I'm going to do during the sermon is I'm going to hand out these little clipboards. And what it says on there is your name, your phone number, address, family or individual, and then it says usher, reader, or if you'd like to help with the altar. So we'll pass those along, kind of like communion plates during the sermon, to see if we can get some other people involved in doing stuff here at the church, since we are the body of Christ together. And often, if I put it in the bulletin, nobody calls and says anything. If I put it over in the gathering room on the table, 8 people sign up. No, this is not just 8 people's church. This is our church. God has placed us here to worship Him and work together. So I'll be doing that during the sermon. Also, if you are one of those individuals who normally take the individual communion kit, we looked at those this week and they were expired. So if you need to have communion, hopefully David got the message. We'll do it after the service. We are going to sneak out. There's a couple people who sit in the lounge. We're going to sneak out after communion in here and go do communion in there. And if you need communion, we'll keep an eye out and we'll bring communion out to you today. And hopefully for our next time we have communion, the ones that we have ordered, the fresh ones, should be here. I think those are all of the announcements that we need to talk about this morning. So we begin our time of worship together by singing our opening hymn, Rise, Shine, You People. Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. We read together the Ten Commandments. You shall have no other gods. You shall not misuse the name of the Lord your God. Remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. Honor your father and your mother. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not give false testimony against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife or his manservant or maidservant, his ox or donkey, or anything that belongs to your neighbor. Let us then confess our sins to God our Father. Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole hearts. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I will sing to the Lord, because he has dealt bountifully with me. Lest my enemies say, I have prevailed over him. Lest my foes rejoice because I am shaken. I will sing to the Lord, because he has dealt bountifully with me. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O Lord, keep your family, the church, continually in the true faith that relying on the hope of your heavenly grace, we may ever be defended by your mighty power through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Please be seated.
The Old Testament reading for the fifth Sunday after the Epiphany is taken from Isaiah chapter 40, verses 21 through 31. Do you not know? Do you not hear? Has it not been told you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is he who sits above the circle of the earth, and its inhabitants are like grasshoppers, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain and spreads them like a tent to dwell in, who brings princes to nothing and makes the rulers of the earth as emptiness. Scarcely are they planted, scarcely sown. Scarcely has their stem taken root in the earth when he blows on them and they wither, and the tempest carries them off like stubble. To whom then will you compare me, that I should be like him, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes on high and see. Who created these? He who brings out their host by number, calling them all by name, by the greatness of his might, and because he is strong in power, not one is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God? Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint, and to him who has no might, he increases strength. Even youths shall faint and be weary, and young men shall fall exhausted. But they who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The epistle is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 16 through 27. If I preach the gospel, that gives me no ground for boasting. For necessity is laid upon me. Woe to me if I do not preach the gospel. For if I do this of my own will, I have a reward, but not of my own will. I am still entrusted with a stewardship. What then is my reward? That in my preaching I may present the gospel free of charge, so as not to make it full use of my right in the gospel. For though I am free from all, I have made myself a servant to all, that I might win more of them. To the Jews I became as a Jew, in order to win Jews. To those under the law I became as one under the law, though not being myself under the law, that I might win those under the law. To those outside the law I became as one outside the law, not being outside the law of God, but under the law of Christ, that I might win those outside the law. To the weak I became weak, that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all people, that by all means I might save some. I do it all for the sake of the gospel, that I may share with them in its blessings. Do you not know that in a race all the runners compete, but only one receives the prize? So run that you may obtain it. Every athlete exercises self-control in all things. They do it to receive a perishable wreath, but we are imperishable. So I do not run aimlessly. I do not box as one beating the air. But I discipline my body and keep it under control, lest after preaching to others, I myself should be disqualified. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Please stand out of respect to the reading of the Holy Gospel as we sing together the Alleluia and verse.
Alleluia, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, the first chapter. Immediately, Jesus left the synagogue and entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Now Simon's mother-in-law lay ill with a fever, and immediately they told him about her, and he came and took her by the hand and lifted her up, and the fever left her, and she began to serve them. That evening at sundown, they brought to him all who were sick or oppressed by demons, and the whole city was gathered together at the door. And he healed many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons. And he would not permit the demons to speak because they knew him. And rising very early in the morning, while it was still dark, he departed and went out to a desolate place, and there he prayed. And Simon and those who were with him searched for him, and they found him and said to him, "Everyone is looking for you." And he said to them, "Let us go on to the next town, that I may preach there also, for that is why I came out." And he went throughout all Galilee, preaching in their synagogues and casting out demons. This is the gospel of the Lord. Please be seated as we sing our sermon hymn, "Fight the Good Fight." Please pray with me. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. From our gospel reading, "And she began to serve them." I thought that was the best part of the sermon, or of the gospel reading. After Jesus heals Peter's mother-in-law, what does she do? She gets up and serves them. And no, I am not saying, just so I don't get myself in trouble, I am not saying that all women should just get up and serve us. No, I'm saying all of us need to get up and serve. All of us, not just a couple, not just a few. God has given to us the greatest message ever. Here it is, in a nutshell. Because of your sins, you all deserve hell. Every single one of us, all over the face of the earth, because of our sinful condition, we all deserve hell. But God, in his love, sent his son Jesus to suffer and die, to take the pain and punishment that my sin, your sins, deserve. He took that upon himself and then rose again victoriously, defeating sin and death and the power of the devil, giving to us the gift of forgiveness of sins. So when God, our Heavenly Father, looks at those who believe in Jesus, when He sees them, He no longer sees their sins. When we repent of our sins, our sins are gone. They're washed away. They are no more. God sees our sins no more. And because we have no sins that God has a record of anymore, then we receive the gift of eternal life. We do. We receive the gift of eternal life. You do. You receive the gift of eternal life because of what Jesus has done for you. As we just sang one of my all-time favorite hymns, Fight the Good Fight. I remember as a little kid singing it in our church, St. John's Lutheran Church in Rodenburg, Illinois. It was on Rodenburg Road. It was in Roselle, Illinois. It was a tiny old farm church. It smelled old. They had wires holding the walls up because it was old, and it was packed. Every Sunday it was packed. And when people would sing this hymn or any hymn they knew, the windows shook. It was so exciting because God has such an amazing message for us. Everybody at that church wanted to be there and be a part of something. Something bigger than themselves, to serve. To not just sit around and let somebody else do it. When we talk about membership of a church, it's not a membership as of a country club, where you simply pay your membership, you go occasionally, you expect to receive stuff back from the membership. And that's all you do. It's kind of like a gym membership, right? I know. I've been paying for one of those for years. And you can see how good that works out for me. I pay every month. They take my money. And every month I go, I've got a membership. And I don't do anything with it. Maybe I should. But when we talk about church membership, it's not like that. When we talk about church membership, we talk about it being the body of Christ because Jesus called us the body of Christ. We are His body. Each and every one of us is 100% a part of the body, and also we are all completely different. Completely different. Some of us can sing very well. Some of us shouldn't sing in public. Some of us can read very well. Others, not their strong suit. So when I pass these out, if I were to sign up, the one area I would not sign up for, reader. I don't like reading. I can talk in public all day long. Reading in public, not one of those things I am really excited about doing. We are called by God to live this life, to be His body together. We are called to do this thing we call church, that He calls church. He's called us to do it together, and all of us have a role here during the worship service, a role helping out with Sunday school or vacation Bible school or the youth ministry. There's all kinds of different areas in which God can call and use you here. But right now, today, we're going to talk about the worship service. So I'm going to pass these out. Here's a pen. There is a pen, and I'm going to go about halfway back. make y'all feel guilty. It's about halfway. And a pen. And a pen. And all I'm looking for is if you are interested in helping. If not, don't feel guilty because it might not be your area of strength. If there's one of those things on there that you're like, yeah, I could do that. I can help usher on a Sunday morning. And if you're like, I can't help usher, have you seen the people who we've had ushering? They are normal, everyday people just like you. There is no incredible, difficult training that is a necessity. We might walk you through it once or twice so you know. But God has called us to do this thing together. The other thing on there is reader, like I said. And if you're one of those people who says, I can read, praise the Lord, you have a special spot in my heart. If by chance you're like, not a chance, just like me, don't mark that one. The other thing on the list is altar. If you like the banners that are up, if you would like to help put out the communion ware or help get the sanctuary prepared each week, you could sign up there. I know our altar guild over the years has lost membership, and there's a few ladies who have been super active, and I'm sure if given the opportunity, would like to take a little time off. Because we do go through different seasons in our lives when the Lord is calling us to different ministries, to different things. So as Peter's mother-in-law got up to serve, we too are called by God to do the same thing. We'll talk later of other things that you might find to do because we're a family. We are in this together. We are brothers and sisters in Christ. I had confirmation kids who asked me this week, if we're all brothers and sisters, does that mean you're married to your sister? And I said, well, this isn't Alabama, but yes, we are all one body, one family together. How awesome is that? God has called us to be a part of the amazing story he has to share about his love and his grace by serving others. What an amazing thing that God, our Heavenly Father, the creator of the universe, has called you. Has called you for a purpose. And some of you might be saying, well, you know, I'm kind of young. God doesn't have a plan for me yet. If you're kind of young, let me tell you this. When we have children's messages up here, and people see you sitting, and the joy and the love in your face, and they see the love of Christ in you, you are sharing the message of hope. Because when you get old like us, it's amazing, it's wonderful to see young faces, young believers who have a lifetime left to serve the Lord. And if you're in that middle school squirrely age group, does God have a purpose for you? Yes. Do you have any friends at school who don't know anything about Jesus? Especially friends who don't know anything about Jesus. You can invite them to things here at church where we'd have the opportunity to share with them. In the last few months, we've had 5 new confirmation students because people have been talking to each other. How awesome is that? If you're a senior high youth, God has a purpose and a plan for you. And it's not just whenever you're ready to go to college, then I'll do something with you. Ask the youth who went to Detroit last summer. God can use us even in places that we are not comfortable with. God can do amazing things. So if you think you're all young, God can't use you, there's another thing coming. Now, if you are college age or young adult, young working individuals, does God have a purpose and a plan for you? Definitely. If you are a middle-aged, chubby guy like me, does God have a purpose and a plan for you? Yes. And if you're not so young, was that politically correct? Not so young? Like Abraham and Sarah when they first had their first child, 190 years old. If you kind of feel like you fit in that age group instead, does God have a purpose and a plan for you? Definitely. Do I know what all those purposes are? No, because I sometimes don't even know what my purpose is. But God does. God has called us. Because of the blood of Christ, he has washed us and set us free. He has cleansed us and made us something new and said, I want you to be a part of this family. I want you to give of yourself. I want you to share of yourself. I want you to be active. Fight the good fight with all your might. With all your might. In our Old Testament reading, there were these words. He gives power to the faint, and to him who has no might, he increases strength. Even youths faint and be weary, and young men shall fall exhausted. But they who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. May God give you the power and the strength to do what he has called you to do. If it's here in the sanctuary, if it's your life at work, if it's with your family or friends, let God use you for the purpose he has called you to be. Let's pray. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we thank you. Lord, we thank you that you have called us to serve, to be an active part of your family, to be an active part of the body of Christ, Lord. We thank you that you have given us opportunities. Lord, we pray that you would open our eyes to not just the three on this list, but Lord, to so many areas in which you have called us, and maybe in ways we don't even know or haven't thought about yet. Maybe it's ministry to those in prison, Lord. Maybe it's ministry to those who are struggling with addiction. Maybe it's those who are in need of financial direction and guidance, Lord. You have gifted us all so completely differently. We thank you for that. Use us, Lord, together as your body so that your name, your story would be proclaimed, that the love of Christ would be told everywhere. We pray in his name. Amen. I invite you to stand as we confess our Christian faith together in the words of the Nicene Creed. And as if the clipboards have not made it all the way to where they were supposed to get, let them keep going or wait till the offering or finish them after the service. Let's confess together our Christian faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father, And he will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshiped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. And I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray for the whole church of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. We give thanks to you, dear Father, for sending your Son, Jesus Christ, into our flesh to preach the gospel and to cast out the works of Satan and the corruption of sin, which we could not overcome. By your word, rescue us from every evil of body and soul. Lord, in your mercy. We pray, Lord, that you would be with George, Yvonne, Brenda, Helen, Janet, Dutch, and all others that are sick or in need of healing. We pray, Lord, that you would bring peace and comfort and your healing to them. Lord, in your mercy. We thank you for Elaine, David, John, Elijah, Matt, Xavier, who celebrate their birthdays this week, and for Marvin and Sharon, who celebrate their anniversary. Remind us, Lord, that every day, every breath is a gift from you, Lord, in your mercy. We pray, Lord, that you'd be with President Biden, Governor Walz, and all of the elected officials of our nation. We pray that you would keep them safe and that you would use them for the purpose for which you have placed them into office. Lord, we pray that you would be with our military men and women around the world. We pray for their safety, Lord. We pray for their safe return. We thank you for their sacrifice so that we would remain safe. We pray, Lord, that you would also be with their families. Be with our police officers, Lord, our firefighters, EMSs, all who put themselves in harm's way for our benefit. Lord, we pray that you would keep them safe. Lord, in your mercy. We pray, Lord, that you would be with all who are struggling with depression or anxiety. We pray, Lord, that you would bring light into the darkness of depression, that they would know that they have value and a purpose, Lord. Give them your peace, Lord, in your mercy. We pray, Lord, that you would bring peace to our world, that you would bring strength to those who are afflicted by cancer. And Lord, we praise you. We praise you for baby Hannah, who's going to be going home. Lord, we thank you that her healing has come more quickly than expected. And we pray, Lord, that you would be with her and her family and her parents as she comes home. Bless them as a family and her as your child. Lord, in your mercy. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. At this time, we'll collect our offerings.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly good, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, for what had been hidden before the foundation of the world, you have made known to the nations in your Son. In him being found in the substance of our mortal nature, you have manifested the fullness of your glory. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and singing. Blessed are you, Lord of heaven and earth, for you have had mercy on those whom you created and sent your only begotten Son into our flesh to bear our sin and to be our Savior. With repentant joy, we receive the salvation accomplished for us by the all-availing sacrifice of his body and his blood on the cross. Gathered in the name and the remembrance of Jesus, we beg you, O Lord, to forgive. Renew and strengthen us with your word and spirit. Grant us faithfully to eat his body and drink his blood as he bids us do in his own testament. Gather us together, we pray, from the ends of the earth to celebrate with all the faithful the marriage feast of the Lamb in his kingdom which has no end. Graciously receive our prayers. Deliver and preserve us. To you alone, O Father, be all glory, honor, and worship with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, in the night when he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to them and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. The peace of the Lord be with you always."
Thank you. Thank you.
Let us pray. We give thanks to you, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through this salutary gift, and we implore you that of your mercy you would strengthen us through the same in faith towards you and in fervent love toward one another. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and give you his peace. Amen. We sing together our closing hymn, "With the Lord, Begin Your Task."